Assalamu alaikum. We are here with another lecture of Public International Law. In this particular lecture, we will discuss about the recognition. What does the word recognition mean? Recognition exactly means when someone accepts you for some particular characteristics or for some particular merits. So, at international level, recognition से क्या मतलब है कि जब आपको सर्टन करेक्टरिस्टिक्स, सर्टन खसूसियात या कुछ सर्टन क्वालिटीज की वजह से किसी पर्टिकुलर फोरम पे रिकग्नाइज्ड किया जाए या किसी पर्टिकुलर फोरम पे आपको एक्सेप्ट किया जाए. इट कैन बी सेड दैट थ्रू रिकग्निशन द रिकग्नाइजिंग स्टेट एक्नॉलेज that the recognized state possesses the essential conditions of statehood, government, sovereignty, a definite territory, and has a complete control over his territory. The community is independent, so recognition has an important place in international law. By recognition, only the state is accepted as a member of international community. So, what does this simply mean? That a state will be acknowledged or recognized only if it would possess some certain qualities. And what are those qualities? Those qualities are statehood, having a government, being a sovereign state, having a defined territory, and having a complete control on your own territory, where the community is independent about their own laws and regulations, about their customs, about their traditions. So, in international law, recognition is very important. So, only a state will be accepted as a member of international community, which will be a recognized state. So, a researcher, or we can say a scientist's opinion, explain recognition as, in recognition, a state as a member of international community, the existing states declare that, in their opinion, the new states fulfill the condition of statehood as required by international law. So, simply means, who basically recognized the state? There's this question. So, this is the answer of that particular question, that the state who are already recognized and they are the members of international community will recognize the existing state. Like, the existing states will recognize a new state. But the recognition could be of three types. First one is state recognition. Second one is governmental recognition. Third one is dispute recognition. Like, when a new state is formed and if have certain qualities of territory, government, population and habitual submission, then ultimately the international community or the recognized states, like already recognized states, have to recognize the new state. Governmental structure, like if a state designed a new governmental structure and ultimately the state has to build relation with other countries as well. So, what the state required? The state required recognition from the international community that yes, they accept that particular governmental structure to basically coordinate or communicate with that particular government. Third one is dispute, recognition of a dispute. Whenever there is a dispute between two or more than two states about some territory or about anything else, that can be highlighted as a dispute or highlighted as something that create conflict between two states, that also needs recognition. Like, the international community has to recognize that yes, it is a dispute that need to be resolved. So we have to infer with state practice, like ultimately if the state practice basically highlights that this particular matter is a dispute, then what the state practice has to get an international recognition about that matter, that to get an approval that yes, it is a dispute. So according to Kelsen, a community to be recognized as an international person must fulfill the following conditions: that anything that needs a recognition must fulfill following conditions. First, the community must be politically organized. Like, there must be a sort of political structure, or there must be some sort of political organization. Then that community would be added as an international community, and yes, it would also be the part of recognition culture. It should have control over a definite territory. As we always talk about, that this is the basic characteristics or basic component of a state, that the state must have a defined territory. Of course, whenever there will be a state, then it would require some sort of recognition. So this is the second characteristics, that the state must have a defined territory. Third, the definite control should tend towards performance. The ultimate control on some particular territory should have some sort of outcome. Like if a political culture is performing in a definite territory, there must be some sort of outcome as well. The community thus constituted must be independent. Like the community should be an independent community. By this particular diagram, I know it is not very, it is not perfect diagram. It is not, maybe it is not right diagram even. But I have just draw this diagram to explain that how, what a basically dispute is and how a dispute basically occur. So before 1947, this whole area was the part of India. In 1947, India was divided, and West Pakistan and then East Pakistan. Let me draw this thing, or let me highlight this thing. This is basically East Pakistan. This is basically West Pakistan. So before partition, this whole area was basically India for 1947. 1947, there happened a partition and India was divided, and there was West Pakistan and there was East Pakistan. Although there was some sort of distance between both of these states, but yes, they were considered as a one independent state. Now, as these parts are divided, they need the recognition by the international community that yes, now this is a separate state. So international community has recognized them that Pakistan is a sovereign state with a defined territory. Then there happens 1971, and what happened? East Pakistan became Bangladesh. So now again, Bangladesh again need recognition by the international community that yes, it is a separate state. As we all know that there was a sort of conflict or sort of discussion in Pakistan, that either Pakistan should recognize Bangladesh as a separate state or not. Later on in 1948, we all know that there was a war between Pakistan and India, and a disputed area was basically arised. This disputed area was basically the area of Kashmir, and we all know the international forum like United Nations has recognized this matter as a disputed matter, and they have asked to resolve this matter mutually, and United Nations will perform its duty to resolve that matter. Now we have like highlighted the two things in it. First one is state recognition. Second one is the recognition of a dispute. Like the international community has accepted or recognized a separate state on the map, and international community has also highlighted the recognition of a dispute. So just to justify the last point, there was this resolution 1172 in 1998 by the United Nations Council, and the Security Council of the United Nations has adopted this particular resolution and declared that Kashmir is a disputed matter and Pakistan and India need a bilateral solution on this particular matter. Like, this is a dispute between Pakistan and India. Kashmir is not even the part of Pakistan, not even the part of India. Both the states need to resolve that matter mutually, and ultimately they need a proper solution for this particular. From this particular slide, we have analyzed this particular thing, that there are two types of recognition: de facto recognition and de jure recognition. The practice of state shows that in first stage, the state generally give de facto recognition. Later on, when they are satisfied that the recognized state is capable of fulfilling international obligations, they confer de jure recognition on it. That is why sometimes it is said that de facto recognition of a state is a step towards the de jure recognition. In this particular slide, we can basically see that her state, her new state, which is formed, it required a recognition. उसे एक पहचान की, उसे एक नाम की, इसके साथ साथ किसी दूसरी स्टेट को उसे रिकग्नाइज्ड करने की जरूरत होती है. फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर रिकग्निशन, उस पर्टिकुलर स्टेट को कुछ करेक्टरिस्टिक्स या कुछ कंडीशंस हैं जिन्हें फुलफिल करना होता है. डिफेक्टो रिकग्निशन का क्या मतलब है कि जैसे ही एक स्टेट फॉर्मुलेट हुई है, वो एक मैप पे एग्जिस्ट किया है उस स्टेट ने, समहाउ स्टेट्स को रिकग्नाइज्ड करना है कि आया क्या ये एक स्टेट है या ये एक स्टेट नहीं है. जैसा कि इजराइल, इनिशियली दुनिया के बहुत से ममालिक ने इजराइल को एज अ स्टेट एक्सेप्ट ही नहीं किया. जैसा कि पाकिस्तान, व्हाट इज दिस कि इनिशियल स्टेप पे ही हमने उसे रिकग्नाइज्ड ही नहीं किया एज अ सेपरेट स्टेट. एज कंपेयर टू दिस, पाकिस्तान ने ईरान या फिर पाकिस्तान ने चाइना, इन सब स्टेट्स को रिकग्नाइज्ड किया, इनकी फॉर्मुलेशन को रिकग्नाइज्ड किया. इनिशियली पाकिस्तान ने बांग्लादेश को एज अ स्टेट रिकग्नाइज नहीं किया था, बट लेटर ऑन वो भी रिकग्नाइज्ड किया. दैट वाज डी फैक्टो रिकग्निशन. डी जूर रिकग्निशन क्या होती है कि जब स्टेट डिफरेंट इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटीज आपके साथ रिलेशनशिप मेंटेन करना चाहती हैं, फर्दर रिलेशनशिप को बिल्ट अप करना चाहती हैं, because now you have all the characteristics or you are fulfilling all the characteristics of being a state. What were those characteristics? As we have discussed earlier, the state must have territory, it must have population, it must have a governmental structure, and it must have some sort of human habitual community. कि तमाम फैक्टर्स हैं जो किसी भी स्टेट में एग्जिस्ट करने चाहिए. तो इस लेक्चर से हमने ये अंदाज़ा लगाया कि रिकग्निशन जो है वो कितनी इम्पॉर्टेंट है. जब तक आप स्टेट को रिकग्नाइज नहीं करते तब तक आप उस स्टेट के साथ अपने ताल्लुकात बढ़ा नहीं सकते. जब तक किसी एक स्टेट को रिकग्नाइज नहीं किया जाता तब तक वो स्टेट समहाउ लिमिटेड स्टेट रहती है. जैसे कि इज़राइल की हमने बात की कि जब पहले इज़राइल को एज अ स्टेट एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया जाता था बाय मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टेट, तो नतीजा क्या था कि इज़राइल को कुछ सेंक्शंस का समहाउ कुछ लिमिटेशंस का सामना करना पड़ता था. बट एज नाउ द UAE and many of the other countries has recognized the Israel as a separate state. Now they have an open up space. इससे पहले इज़राइल के लोग दुबई जो है वो या यूनाइटेड अरब एमिरेट्स जो है वहाँ पे मूव नहीं कर सकते थे, वहाँ आ जा नहीं सकते थे. As Pakistanis and Israelis can't go and come to both these countries. Because they both the state haven't recognized each other. Or basically Pakistan haven't recognized the Israel because Israel was a new state. इसी तरह से पाकिस्तान ने बांग्लादेश को as a new state recognized किया. Later on they have somehow built their relation. Now the member of both the states can come and go forward in each of the state. So this is how the recognition is very important. जब भी किसी स्टेट में कोई डिस्प्यूट होगा उसको रिकग्नाइज करना भी बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. जैसे कि इज़राइल और फलस्तीन का इशू जो है उसको इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटी रिकग्नाइज करती है कि येस देर इज दिस डिस्प्यूट. पाकिस्तान और इंडिया के दरमियान कश्मीर के मैटर को इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटी रिकग्नाइज करती है कि येस देर इज दिस डिस्प्यूट. इसके अलावा भी दुनिया में और बहुत सारे मैटर्स हैं. इसके बाद आगे जी गवर्नमेंट के बाद सेम इसी तरह से जब एक स्टेट अपना गवर्नमेंटल स्ट्रक्चर बिल्कुल चेंज करती है तो उसको अपने गवर्नमेंटल स्ट्रक्चर को रिकग्नाइज कराने की ज़रूरत होती है कि येस वी आर फॉलोइंग अ राइट पाथ. So this is how the recognition and the whole process basically work. In next lecture, we will study in detail about the de facto and de jure recognition. Inshallah. Thank you so much. This is it for today. Hope to see you in the next lecture.